but am everlasting God in heaven.
It was on CCTV. And even with CCTV, the police will not prosecute the men that beat him up. He has a broken nose, he has a broken elbow, he broke his fibula as well.
You are Antichrist! You are Antichrist!
You are Antichrist! You are social media!
Why are the Lebanese to communicate each other? Why is this so successful?
Come here, come here, Dad!
Where is successful?
It says in the Quran!
Where is successful?
The children of Israel will return! They have done! Alan got it right!
We haven't.
And so many fouls are going unnoticed! Where is the linesman? Why is only one linesman in the world holding his flag out? The world is offside! Now!
Are you pro-Euro?
Am I pro-Euro? A very good question. I want you to know, whether we remain in Europe or whether you vote Brexit, England will still be out of the Euros before the 23rd. I can guarantee you that.
When he did this, the police officer jumped up and said, Your Honour, new evidence has come to court, we no longer support. That was it. That was it. So, secrets. And I remember being in Labour Party in 1980. The Masons decided to vote this way on this, this and this. It was just a story of who the Masons were and what they voted for. It wasn't about which party it was. It was the Masons or not Masons.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Speaker's Corner. I'm sure you've been inundated with well wishes from your orators. I walk to Rome as I often do to find the get a sense of the vibe, the tone that was going on. And not surprisingly, the big topic of the day wasn't being mentioned by the other speakers. As far as I know, I haven't been here very long. But I thought I really must come and try and say something about next Thursday. It's a peculiarity of the British that we have our elections on a Thursday. This coming Thursday isn't another general election. It's not a local election, certainly. It's something much bigger than that. It's the second of our referendums concerning the European Union, the EU, as it is at the moment. And of course, it's going to evolve into the United States of Europe. That's the agenda. When I voted for in the original referendum, I voted for remaining in the EEC, the European Economic Community, and that had changed to the EEC, the European Community. The economic word was quietly dropped because it's much more than just an economic idea. It's much more than just a trading bloc with low tariffs or no tariffs. It's actually a political project to have something like the United States of America, the United States of Europe. And the idea is that the USE is going to, be like the USA, and then there'll be another block in the east centered around Japan. That's the agenda of the architects of the New World Order. That's how they see it. But it may not pan out that way. Certainly, the two camps are called Leave and Remain, and I of course am from leaving. I want to leave this phony project which was sold to us as a trading bloc, but it's really something much more sinister. It's sinister because the people running it, the people who appear to be running it at least, are not elected by us or anybody else. We don't elect them, they're appointed. People say, yeah, but our elected representatives appoint them. But the trouble is, when they're appointed, how do you actually decide, change your mind? How do they be unappointed? Seems almost like a job for life. So for example, Neil Kinnock, the Labour guy, was an EU commissioner. Very suspicious Tory candidate. Ian Britton was investigated as a potential member of these high-level paedophile rings, these kiddie-fiddling outfits. We have to assume the man's innocent until proven guilty, but of course he's conveniently out of the way over there in Europe. And George Robertson, my compatriot, has went off apparently to NATO and has never been heard of since. And George Robertson's been implicated apparently in the Masonic Lodge, Heiko was talking about Masonry earlier, which is unusual for Heiko, centered around the mass child killer Thomas Hamilton up in Scotland. So this Thursday we have a referendum which was called by the Prime Minister David Cameron, really under pressure, long-term pressure from UKIP, the United Kingdom Independence Party, and Nigel Farage, who is in the institutions of Europe, who is over in Brussels and knows what these things are like, as does the Conservative MEP, member of the European Parliament, Daniel Hannan. And Daniel Hannan is a very articulate advocate of getting out of Brexit. Brexit means Britain exiting the European Union as it currently is. But all the people who are poised to remain, to vote remain, don't realise that it isn't going to remain. It's changing all the time, and it's evolving into this USE, United States of Europe. So, I think on Thursday, this coming Thursday, I think there'll be a vote to remain. I think people will be timid. I think there'll be, they'll play safe. Better the devil you know, as the saying people use. And I think they'll do that. But I think there'll be a sizable contingent for Brexit, including myself and Naim, who's holding the camcorder. Of course, things got skewed a bit by the murder of the Labour MP, Jo Cox. She, of course, is for Remain, but it wasn't a particular passion of hers. She just was towing the party line. I mean, there's been any amounts of eulogies, and everyone seems to know Jo Cox, and they all were her best buddies, and they all knew how wonderful she was. But truth be told, many of them probably weren't really aware of her until she was suddenly taken from her family and so forth. And there was her children in a dinghy protesting against Nigel Farage's flotilla, wanting to remain in. I don't know how safe it is to have young children in a dinghy on the Thames. I know they live in a barge, the family lived in a barge with Joe there, but her death, of course, has caused people, there's a campaign to postpone or abandon the referendum vote on Thursday because of the murder of Joe Cox. There's certainly a move towards people going back to saying, well, we should remain for Joe's sake. But what we're remaining in, ladies and gentlemen, is inherently fascist. It's not in any real sense democratic. And a vote for Brexit on Thursday is a vote to regain a sense of democracy. People quote the House of Lords as an example of an unelected institution. Well, that doesn't mean because we don't sign up to the United States of Europe, it doesn't mean that everything in Blighty, everything in Britain is fine. Far from it. And indeed, I would like to see a move towards, I've talked before, my ideas is to have abolish the House of Lords and abolish the House of Commons, replace them with the House of Appointees and the House of Electives, respectively. But the big decision is this Thursday, and I think it's been somewhat tempered by the murder of Jo Cox. And there's been some dispute as to whether her killer actually said Britain first or not. Britain First, it turns out, is described as a far-right group. Now, they're one of the tenets of Britain First is that there are way too many Muslims here. Indeed, they're questioning whether there should be Muslims in what is supposedly a Christian country. That's perhaps a dispute for a later time, another time. But the present difficulty is, how can we get out of this monster and regain control of our life, regain control of our country, and evolve Britain towards a democracy where the elected representatives are answerable to the people in a way that the EU officials are not answerable to the people. And then we moved, there's a whole world out there. I mean, I've said before that we moved to young people, we should move from being 128th Britain, which is what we are at the moment. We're continually outvoted in the European Union, and that's not surprising because we are not part of the main bloc, which is the Europe, called the Eurozone. These are the countries which subscribe to the euro currency, and they form what's called the Eurozone. And how could Britain or the United Kingdom possibly have a say, an equal say, in the European Union when we're not members of the Eurozone, we don't use the euro currency? And indeed, has been pointed out several times, many of the advocates for remaining are the same people who frightened us, what would happen, terrible things would happen if we didn't adopt the euro. But we're all glad now that we didn't adopt the euro, but it means we're sort of half in and half out. So those who want to remain, and I respect your democratic choice, but you have to ask yourself, what is it that makes you want to remain? You can't take the murder of an MP, as outrageous and hopefully as unique as that is, as your rationale, because the long-term agenda is, as I say, to move to a federal super state. So if you want to remain, what you're sort of half remaining and half in and half out, because we're not in the euro, right? And because we're not in the euro, we can't possibly have the clout and the say that other countries. We all know, or at least you should know, that the project is built on keeping the peace between France and Germany, who are historical enemies. But the peace in Europe has been maintained by NATO, and of course, it turns out that the Soviet Union and today Russia has no intention, has no interest in invading Europe. Indeed, they have their nuclear missiles, which we try and pretend are some kind of threat, but that's their idea of deterrence. They're trying to deter us. And even so, they're still being surrounded by NATO countries and NATO members, and I find that very provocative and unhelpful. But back here in London at Speaker's Corner, the issue is, should we remain or should we leave? And like the videographer there, Nine, we are for leaving, getting out of this thing, and getting back our integrity, getting back our ability to control our own life as a remarkable island people. And we can be great again, we can be a new GB, where GB means global Britain. If only we can believe in ourselves and achieve this. There will be a difficulty for a couple of years if we were to leave, but as I say, I think that's unlikely. I think the vote will be, the referendum will be for Remain. I think people will play safe, which is a shame, but I'm reminded by the spirit guide Ramallah, who back in the 1970s said how it was regrettable that Britain had chosen to get involved in federation with other countries in Europe and had delayed its destiny. And Ramallah said something interesting. He said, in the years to come, this was about a book published in 1978, The Revelations of Ramallah. Ramallah said to his advanced group of students at Glastonbury, one of the spiritual centers of the world, Ramallah said, in the years to come, you'll see that the common market is not what you think it is. Indeed it isn't. But the good news is that Ramallah said we will find release from it. So if it's not at this gentle referendum with a ballot box and so forth, it will come after much difficulty, much trouble in Europe, which will come in through the tunnel and across the channel and affect us. And we'll remind ourselves that the solution is to get out of this place. We are an island, and it's not so terrible to be a little insular at times. Thank you for listening, ladies and gentlemen. God bless you.